My design principles are very clear. First of all, building and site must achieve a fit. And that comes from proper grading. And I learned that from Arthur Erickson. My first impression of Venice was that I was excited to see a town that was able to withstand all the storms and the inlets from the sea. The canals were most impressive. When I came upon the pavilion in 2016, I found that the grades around the building are such that makes access very difficult, and that it needed to have connecting paths between the British pavilion and the German pavilion, so that it was part of an exploration to go from one pavilion to the next. The landscape architect has to think very hard how people will use the site in the 21st century and how we can create platforms and walkways for better accessibility to the whole site, which is the cafe and the Belvedere. Longing for the Garden of Paradise is built into our genes. Throughout history, we have been influenced by the gardens of ancient Egypt, Mesopotamia, Greece, Rome, and Asia, which continue to inspire our contemporary gardens around the world. The new style of garden, with climate change and also economic restraint, is called wilding, which means that you take the plant material of the ecology of the region in which you're working and let it just develop by itself. And I believe strongly if we plant plants from our ecology and not from exotic places, that they will withstand climate change, frost, water, thunderstorms, big storms, and if the garden has a structure that's even better, then they can't be destroyed. And the longing for nature, says E.O. Wilson, is built into our genes. And if we do not satisfy that, then man will be not able to function properly.